If you want to start building solid models in Inventor or really any other system, you have to first begin with a sketch and getting a feel for how to create a sketch. To start out, let's create a template. In this case, we'll use a metric template, so we'll be sketching in metric units. Once the file opens, we can just start drawing. In this case, we can use the marking menu. Just moving straight north, we get our line tool. As we move around, you see we get angle. In this case, it's showing that it's horizontal. We can set a distance. Here, we can set a length for our line, hit the tab key, and then enter an angle for the line. And we'll get exactly what we asked for with parametric dimensions. By moving around and gesturing over components, you'll see that we get different alignments, whether it be vertical, perpendicular, parallel, horizontal. Let's go ahead and move near our object, and you'll see that we can automatically get parallel. As we come to the end of our sketch, we get a nice little green dot to show us that it'll be coincident. So here we have our first basic sketch. We can reposition the dimensions if we want to. We can also start to make modifications. For example, let's take a look at the constraints that have been applied. For example, you see the line on the left and the line on the bottom are perpendicular, parallel, and horizontal. And we can make modifications to how these things were defined. So, even though we've shut these constraints off as far as visibility goes, they're still there. If I delete this dimension, I can then go ahead and see what degrees of freedom we have in our sketch. Here we can drag this around. The line on the right shows a curved arrow, so it can change angle. Now let's start refining this. So if I add perpendicularity, you'll see the curved arrow goes away because that angle can no longer be changed. By creating a horizontal constraint between the center of the sketch and the left edge, that locks it in vertically. By creating a vertical constraint, that locks it in horizontally. So now our sketch is centered on the origin of our part. I can create relationships or make changes to dimensions. So here I've just simply changed the value of that dimension. I can, however, refer to other dimensions by simply selecting on them and then equating them just by leaving that value. If the dimension value changes, just by entering a different number, in this case, let's go ahead and create an equation by saying that width equals 100. So that will now create a named value for that dimension and call it width. If we edit this, you'll see that that dimension is equal to width. Another way to constrain things, though, is to not use a dimension, but to use a geometric constraint. In this case, we can simply tell the vertical lines that they're the same size, they're equal to the horizontal lines. This frames everything together. Some of the other things we can do in a sketch, for example, we can just pick a piece of geometry and say edit sketch with the heads up display. We can create patterns. Let's take this hole. Let's create a pattern of these holes or these circles. Set the distance. We'll set the number that we want in one direction, and we can set the same for the other direction. Now, one thing that's important to know, both in the solid modeling environment and the sketching environment in Inventor, is that these directions do not have to be perpendicular to one another. In this case, they are, and we get a nice pattern of circles in our sketch. We also have the capability of taking different sketches and creating sketch blocks. These sketch blocks behave as though they're separate components inside of an assembly, and they have the ability to be constrained to one another and move. Let's go ahead and create a new block out of the pink geometry at the top. We'll call that our link. Establish our name, link 2. We pick the geometry that we want. Okay, and then we can set our insert point for this geometry. All right, that looks pretty good. We'll say OK, and you'll notice in the browser we now have a link 2 component. The numbers that you see behind the link 1 component are the instances. So we have 3 instances. I drag this down and the insert points connect, and watch how I can move the assembly around, and simply dragging the links to one another, we've now built a full linkage that can be articulated just inside the sketching environment. Now, if we make a change, for example, to the length of link 1, and we go ahead and update our sketch, you'll see that everything follows through and all of the instances are updated together. Now we've got a sketch and we want to go ahead and create a solid model. So we tell it to extrude, but we get a surface model. We were expecting a solid model. If we tell it to give us a solid model, we see that we have a problem. In this case, we have an open loop, so there is a gap somewhere in our sketch. We have the ability through the sketch doctor to interrogate the sketch and to find out what is missing. So it says that there are sketch points. It highlighted them. There's a gap there. It's been closed. And now we have the ability to go ahead and create our complete model. Okay. If we add one too many dimensions, Inventor won't over-constrain the sketch. It gives us instead the opportunity to create a driven dimension, which will follow any changes to the geometry. This has just been a quick overview of sketching, but in just this quick overview, you've seen a lot of the common functions that you will need to learn to start doing part modeling inside of Autodesk Inventor.